We'll be seeing more of them, e.g. to play the winners of this series that we've now got on our hands, kicking off DC versus Wings, winner to play e.g. next series, the final series of the day. And the draft begins. Anything we're going to see in terms of the first picks, first bans, that's going to be very different from the series we've just had?
Respect DC's Warlock. Just classic. Yeah. Just classic just Warlock. Batriders.
Yeah, Batrider. I think the Coddle is, we kind of said it like during the, before the game actually started, that
it's a way that like DC might have wanted to play against.
Yeah, Wings. Just yeah. A good way for DC to play. It's just a hero that can be
it's a hero
abused.
DC loves.
Yeah.
And Wings can play it. The times that I've seen Wings pick it up, they've done very, very well with it. But maybe a hero that DC likes a little more than they like. And Wings, we kind of refer to Wings as like the most versatile team, so they don't really mind banning out some of their favorite heroes.
Timbersaw ban actually going to be coming through from DC, so it means your Venno's there, your Warlock's there. I mean, Venno, of course, a hero that both of these teams like.
DC's been loving the Sand King a lot, too. People have been banning it, like, first two versus them.
Yeah.
Have they been picking it up first, do they? Or has it always kind of been the third pick if it's left in? Like, did they ever pick it up as early as the first two DC?
Which hero?
Sand King?
SK. It's normally second.
I think it was second phase.
Yeah. That hero has fallen out of favor quite a bit.
Yeah.
He's... 5 seconds. It's still good. It's just, it's tough. Like you see a Warlock, and you don't think like, all right, time to pick up Sand King.
Yeah.
DC's and it's cool. I like this Beastmaster pick. It kind of sets the tone for where this game's going. Wings picks, first picks Warlock, huge teamfight hero, low mobility, doesn't deal with split push, doesn't have lockdown. They pick a Beastmaster that's going to give them control of the vision game. It's going to allow them to split push. It's going to allow them to catch people when their split push forces Wings to separate. And a really solid pick. We'll see how Wings reacts to this kind of vision split push approach that DC is most likely headed towards.
I feel like we've seen like Beastmaster Ogre be picked up like so often. Just this combination of the two.
Ogre's gotten a lot of popularity, and it was a hero I wasn't a huge fan of, but I'm starting to really come around to him. I think that like just the max Bloodlust build on like a five position hero is kind of nice, and he really does salvage your laning phase in a lot of ways. He kind of just gives you one lane that. You can win,
yeah,
for sure. So,
yeah, and as we saw, just kind of the play that EG were pulling off, where he was teamed up with Samael in the mid lane, just the fact you can use the Bloodlust to get your mid laner out of there from a gank. You can also just run at heroes with the Ogre. It's very, very versatile. But DC with their opening two, Beastmaster and Rubick. Something we expected, Charlie, or something a little bit different?
I agree with Peter. I like the Beastmaster pick a lot.
Yeah.
It sort of offers, it's like the other end of the spectrum from the Warlock. Rubick is like, you know, one of those very flexible heroes. Doesn't say too much about your draft.
Luna.
I mean, surely if you're you've got to ban out the SD, haven't you? I mean, it's great with Luna. It's great against Beastmaster. Or
it's not the best support combo, Warlock Shadow.
Yeah.
But SD Luna is a beast of its own, so definitely might warrant a ban here. Rubick pick was a little out of left field, but it's a hero they're comfortable with it. And that's totally fine. It's a very neutral pick. It doesn't really give away anything in terms of strategy. The Fade Bolt will be very nice for defending this kind of push lineup we're starting to see out of Wings Gaming. And no field, not bad to have against Luna. And Luna spells are pretty great ones to steal.
Yeah, Rubick, most of Warlock spells are pretty good to steal too. Shadow Ward probably the least effective later on in instances, but...
Interesting that DC ban out the SK ban. You were talking about obviously how DC do like to play it. They obviously still respect it in terms of not wanting it to be played against them.
Yeah, DC's got to be careful that the Wings team fight isn't too overwhelming, because no matter how much you split push, eventually Wings Gaming with this Luna is going to walk down a lane, and if you don't have the team fight to fight them, then you're just going to lose the game.
Yep.
So let me ask: do you think they picked the Luna a bit early?
The Luna pick does kind of give away the direction of their game, which isn't necessarily a bad thing. The carry pick is a little bit early, but they're confident in this like matchup where they're not too worried about the carry that DC is going to pick. So most teams want to wait to pick their carry until they see the carry of the other team, which is not what Wings has done this time around.
Guess we'll see if that comes around to bite them. What would you do to punish Red here?
For which side?
For DC. They reveal their carry.
Oh. Well, I think you really just need to start picking some team fight. I think that this Rubick Beastmaster combo, very, very weak team fight. So you need to get something that allows you to actually take these fights, potentially like a tier 1 tower. Rubick AA has been a very classic kind of support duo, and AA will punish teams that group up to hit your tower. So Beastmaster, I think, is mostly going to be a split push hero this game. I don't really see him engaging in team fights. So finding a team that can just kind of 4v5 while Beastmaster split pushes might be the way to go for DC.
DC banning out Invoker. And of course, as we talked about, SD still being left in the pool if Wings do want to go for the SD Luna tried and tested combination. Now Wings to take away DC's Io. So indeed, maybe eliminating more potential of joining up and building on that Beastmaster split push potential that DC might have looked to do so with an Io pickup.
Yeah, the Bounty Hunter ban is trying to think about what the thought process is behind it.
Is it to protect some kind of jungle pick maybe from Wings?
I don't think so.
No.
I think they're more so concerned about the idea that Bounty Hunter can go in the back lines and place wards, which would definitely prevent them from doing any split push, but I don't really think they wanted to split push against this Beastmaster.
Yeah. I've been literally just looking at the bounty, thinking, trying to understand.
Undying definitely fits into that kind of 4v5 fight mentality.
Yep.
I like the pick. It's a really strong dual lane, too. Beastmaster Undying, if they wanted to challenge the lane. Luna tri-lanes are tough to challenge, so DC might want it default to just jungling their Beastmaster. Beastmasters love to jungle. I think they prefer to jungle. But we'll see what kind of third support hero Wings picks. If it's too weak, they might try and duel in offlane. And we could even see an aggro trialing out of DC if Beastmaster has a favorable matchup in the safe lane.
That's what they've been doing a lot of the games, especially.
That's what they did at TI.
Yep. That's what it was winning
the
games.
They gave Mu this Beastmaster, his Timbersaw, maybe a Sand King. Hero he's super comfortable on. Give him a 1v1 matchup that he's supposed to win, and let him play his hero.
Any room still here for Wings to go for Venno and kind of work with the Fatal Bonds combination and such?
They could do a Venno mid. Rubick's kind of okay against Venno. Undying is pretty okay against Venno, too, because you have a lot of heal.
That's different, though.
Is that more likely to be a Core Shaker, or is that the pairing with Warlock?
I think that's most likely to be a... No, I couldn't tell you. I could tell you. 10 seconds.
But you could tell me what you would prefer. If you were drafted, where would you be putting the Shaker?
Well, I think Earthshaker is just not a great hero.
Yeah.
Right now. He can kind of work in like a Luna tri-lane because your Warlock and Luna will be able to right-click so much, especially if you Fissure block someone, they're going to get so many more right-clicks, which makes it okay. But just kind of an underwhelming and slow hero in most cases. He used to be picked to kind of sit around mid and like protect your mid laner, or you can Fissure block the offlane to secure your offlane or some farm.
Yeah.
So maybe they'll kind of pick like a less viable offlaner who can't necessarily lane solo up there, or at least that needed some help.
Lots of team fight though. Or Shaker, Luna, Warlock once they get online.
DC with that Morphling pick, I mean, so far, are Wings really kitted out to deal with the power of a Morphling?
They got to be ready for this split push. It's coming.
Yeah.
It's going to be a battle of split push versus ability to force team fights. Wings pushing towers, trying to get DC to react to them, and DC split pushing towers, trying to get Wings to react to them. So it's going to be a clever balance, and Wings has an opportunity to pick something that could potentially really limit split push. We'll just have to see if that's the route they go. Or they could pick something that could just help them push towers even faster.
We'll see. As Wings think about this fourth pick, and we'll start to get a bit more of an eye onto where this Earthshaker is going to be placing. I mean, at Wings as well, they are a team that has done the Warlock core in the past, haven't they?
I was actually just thinking I wouldn't even mind an AA support and then a Warlock mid.
Yeah.
That could be really interesting.
AA looks very good, yeah. I mean, versus the Morph and the Undying. And then obviously, just for the more...
I was talking to our manager, Phil. He is the resident Undying expert. It's the only hero he plays. prefers to play it in the Haunted Coliseum.
Okay.
Whoa.
But Ancient Apparition is the biggest counter to Undying.
Yeah, it really hurts him throughout all stages, but this is an interesting pickup.
Yeah, Night Stalker. To deal with the morphing for sure, isn't it?
Old school way to counteract like the vision game as well, like against the Beastmaster.
Yeah.
But yeah, the silence and everything will be decent to have like some catch out too.
Yeah, that's Night Stalker's one of the best heroes to limit split push once he comes online.
Yep. Do you think it's enough though? It's Beastmaster, Morphling, and then you have like a very immobile Warlock, immobile Shaker.
Well, I mean, the thing is like now Wings can go late game, whereas before they couldn't, because they would eventually just lose in the split push vision war. So, a different approach to the game. They're probably going to want another hero that can have some catch, because Luna and Warlock lack that. If they don't pick another catch hero, they're totally dependent on Night Stalker and Earthshaker securing kills on a split pushing Morphling, which I think is very low percentage. 10 seconds remaining. But definitely an option. Beastmaster, really not liking where he's at in a game like this at this point.
Yep.
So with that pick as well, the Knights, that's lending it to be likely that is what Night Stalker Warlock support combo, Korra, Shaker, Cyclone Luna.
So the thing is now DC up against this Night Stalker, they can't really play the split push game, so they have to be more ready to push towers and team fight, which they don't have a bad lineup to do. Rubick, Beastmaster, Undying, Morphling, especially if Morphling kind of goes away from that E-Blade build I talked about in previous casts, maybe doing that Dragonlance Manta build where you can hit towers and you know, just push. They still have really great team fight. Warlock, Luna, Earthshaker is a lot of team fight, so we might have one of these games where the teams are just fighting, and the team that plays better wins.
Well, there we have a hero, of course, great with the Warlock Fatal Bonds, and a hero that's certainly going to add to the fight potential. And vision-wise, it's going to be great. Yeah, getting everyone under the Moonlight Shadow, having Night Stalker, reducing the vision of DC. Wings, they're going to have a lot of chances to get good jumps onto DC this game, it feels.
Like the Alchemist ban a lot. Illusion split push hero. It's a hero that can push lanes without being there, which is one of the things Night Stalker really doesn't like. He wants heroes to be forced to actually go into lanes and try and split push.
And so that's a mid morph?
Morph and Slark on the same team together. That's kind of...
It could be Slark mid.
Okay.
I think that they were definitely looking for a PMS hero to match up against that Morana.
A core Night Stalker as well.
You get a PMS and a Quelling Blade, and you can kind of see us all over Morana, especially before until she gets like 3 points in Starstorm, I would say, without being punished. So, cool last pick. Doesn't offer a lot of team fight. He's kind of cool because he has night vision for the Night Stalker, but once darkness comes out and a gem, I think Slark has some struggles, and Earthshaker's pretty good against Slark, I think.
Yeah, I feel like that's a pretty greedy Slark pick, just with the Morphling. Like, they take a very long time to actually be able to do anything, while Wings ideally wants to just push and go with the Luna, right?
What would be another melee, like, agility hero they could put mid to replace that Slark, though? That's what I'm trying to think.
There was Jug left, right?
I don't know.
It's not that good.
Yeah, there was Jug left.
It gives Jug a healing ward, right? It would have been good.
Jug would have been very good. I don't know if it was still in the pool. Uh-huh. Could have been banned.
I don't. How many times have we seen Wii play it?
That's the thing. Yeah, I haven't seen Wii play Jug ever.
That's very true.
At the same time, though, this is a lot of, like you guys said, this is a lot of AoE for Slark to be fighting in.
Yeah, he's got like the. I mean, Night Stalker is naturally pretty damn good versus him as well. Like, if you get the silence off, if you're able to, without him having Dark Pact, obviously Earthshaker is excellent versus him. I mean, Sumail's Morana is very good versus Slark.
Yeah, you think Slark's good against Morana, but we saw Sumail the other day just arrowing Slark while he was Shadow Danced and just, you know, coming out of that invulnerability just stunned.
So overall, you feel that Wings, just with the better kind of lineup to execute here?
I think the drafts are pretty even. I think a lot is up to Wii and the Slark and how he plays it and what he's able to do.
I mean, is he going to have like the Rubick of the Undying sit mid with him, do you think, or in terms of lanes? Or will we just play the Slark safe lane and they'll put Rezo mid on the Morphling? What are the lanes going to be from DC?
I think that Slark's definitely going to be mid with that PMS.
Yep.
That's going to allow him to farm there. My one concern for DC is I talked about them wanting to have some team fights so they could defend their towers against this Luna Warlock. I don't know if they have enough. Undying is great for that, but he's just an Undying at the end of the day, and it's just him trying to do this. So Wings might have the potential to really push early and take, you know, down a lot of tier ones and take some map control. And the more towers they take in the earlier game, the faster that Night Stalker Aghanim's is going to come online, and that's when DC is really going to struggle.
I think there's a lot of pressure on Moonmeander here to get something going in the early game for DC, because your cores are a Slark and a Morphling. They're not going to be doing very much in the first 10 minutes.
Yeah, I mean, they're playing for like the hard split push late game.
Yeah, that's what, that's what I was getting at. If Wings lines up to push your towers, do you have like a Rubick to fade bolt and an Undying to, you know, throw a tomb or something? Morphling, Slark, and Beastmaster.
Yeah, they don't want to.
They're not even
going to
show up.
Yeah, they're not even going to go.
We'll see how it pans out as we get ourselves stuck into this game one. Wings versus DC. Loser to go home. Winner to move on against EG.
Really cool approach though by Wings. I really like the Nightstalker pick. It's like a hero that we don't really see anymore, but it like actually fits so naturally versus the Beastmaster. It's super good versus the Morphling, and then it's pretty good versus Slark. And it's a core that you can scale pretty decently.
Yeah, trying to fight it. Good fish onto three. The arrow to follow through onto Misery. Misery's got the three-man decay. He'll try and ward this one off, but they've got another Void up. And Wings, they should look to take first blood here. And indeed they do. Blink to get it as well on the mid lane Mirana. So a fantastic start for him there.
Both bounty runes as well.
Both bounty runes, yeah. That was very clever for them to send the three top.
Undying porting top instantly. Going to be really tough for Beastmaster to lane down here, and he opted not to go for that Iron Talon build, so he is kind of committed to laning.
Who got the
He's got a friend. He's got a friend. Never mind.
Who got the first blood? It was the Mirana, right?
Yeah, Mirana.
So he's
got
a Killa level one right
Killa
away.
Killa and the rune.
Yeah, this is necessary, though. Beastmaster definitely needed a friend in this lane.
Yep.
And is this a case of just making sure Moon gets far more, or can the two of them, the Rubick and such, put a lot of pressure on the Luna? Is Luna going to have struggles here?
No, I think it's still a lost lane for DC. I just think that Beastmaster will actually be able to lane and get experience for now.
Fabian again. Going over some hits onto Misery. They do have to be careful, of course, in this lane. A good Fissure block could spell a bit of a disaster as such, but...
Yeah, maybe. I think it's the same situation for DC, though. This is a lost lane for Wings, most likely.
They're just being a nuisance.
Depending on how much CS this Nightstalker gets. He picks up like a PMS and a Quelling and you just start CSing over this Morphling. Not a lot Morph can do, but pretty even laning phase, I would say.
And do you think we're going to see the lane stay pretty static? No one to move around? Any attempts on mid lane ganks as such? Or is it just not worth the time?
You might see the Earthshaker.
Yeah.
The Earthshaker move. Maybe try and set up a Fissure into Arrow.
Nice Fissure.
Oh, nice thick charges as well.
Damn, that was very close to getting that kill.
So Blink as well took a bit of a beating in the mid lane. He's only holding onto a Fairy Fire. Probably got some more regen out on that curry though.
Yeah, I think their idea is just to stop Morphling from free farming.
Yeah.
I don't think they can expect them not to farm, but maybe preventing him from free farming is going to slow down.
I mean, surely there's, if this game does go on and say we're seeing an hour spectacle, having late game Slark and Morphling, can Wings really deal with that, or is there going to be a point where it's going to be very hard for Wings to win the game?
I think Nightstalker Aghs.
It's just so good.
He kind of wins out in every late game situation. Mm-hmm. It's nice that Morphling has a replicate and kind of would get away, but they can definitely pop his Lincolns and silence him before he can get anything off.
Sacks are down here. That's a DD as well to help out with this one. White to Shadow Word himself, looking to walk out, but the heals aren't going to be enough. The damage too much with that DD. And DC getting themselves a kill on this bottom lane. Get a few punches in onto Shadow as well, forcing him back.
It's a pretty big kill.
Yeah, Rubick with DD is a scary guy.
Give some nice little boost of XP, and like you said, like this wasn't a winning lane. This is them just trying to give the Beastmaster a good start, and that's like more than optimal.
Yeah, it's looking a lot better for them in this lane, that's for sure. And Nightstalker continuing to struggle much more than this Beastmaster.
We being forced back to base, picking up some regen. Is this pretty much how you expect the mid lane to go for Blink to have this slight edge? Or
well, he got the first blood.
Yeah,
that certainly helped.
Yeah. Makes a big difference for sure.
Yeah, I thought Slark would win early, and then Mirana would start catching up once he got some levels, but maybe that first blood is the reason that we had to go back to base there, so potentially a one lane here for Wings.
Top lane. A little bit of pressure being put onto Resolution. Again, he's fine. Fabian finding himself level 4 CS-wise. Getting himself a little bit from this off lane. Fabian. And safe lane farm. Looking pretty even for both sides. We are seeing, of course, down with Bon Luna just with a slight edge. But very, very close at the moment. And in these first 4 minutes, even or is there anyone that's going to be a little bit more satisfied with how this laning stage is going?
think laning phase benefits. I don't know. I think it's very even.
It's fairly, yeah, it's fairly even.
This is nice. Saxo TPing in. He had a haste rune, immediately looking to set up onto Faith Bian. Ice Ice with a Fisher trying to hold back the Lalan to turn. It's not going to work. They'll lose the Nightstalker. And as we've seen, Saxo with some two pretty godly runes. You know, had the DD bottom, gets a kill, has a haste rune, comes top, and sets up another for DC. And cancels a clarity on the way out as well of Ice Ice.
And that tends to be the problem with Earthshaker. Like, you know, you say he's falling out of favor and stuff. He can't really do anything but just be a Fissure.
Yeah.
Like, if there was any other hero there who could, like, actually auto-attack or anything, give some more, like, help to the Nightstalker, you know, they'd actually maybe have gotten a kill there as a trade. But, you know, he's just a Fissure right now.
Yep, absolutely. But that's not Earthshaker's... That is, like, Earthshaker's weakness, but in late game, he gets, you know, very strong.
Yeah.
He gets his Blink Dagger and Mana Boots, and he's a whole different hero.
Faith Bian coming back and playing very aggressively there.
Yeah, Morphins.
Resolution. No stick charges. He'll have a bit of mana to morph up with.
Gosh, Nightstalker stuck. I'd like to see Nightstalker get a Quantum Blade.
Just going back in and trading hits with Reza. Faith Bian. That's the mango as well if he wants to play aggressive.
They're messing with the Morphling's farm a bit though.
Yeah.
They're going to make him have to bring regen. Yeah, exactly. They're going to make him like actually just spend a little bit more gold on that too while the Luna's having quite a free time even though they lost the Warlock in the laning phase.
Coming up for a smoke gank as well, Wings. Bringing Blink up on Morana. Faith Bian trying to bait a bit of interest from DC.
He's got the mango for the silence.
So jump in, Blink, and yeah, silence onto the Morph before he gets the chance to start Morphing. They'll get the stun through. Silence steal will now end. So Resolution starting to morph up. Waveforms up to the north. He'll survive.
Lost vision.
That was a super low percentage play.
Yeah.
I'd say. But good try, I suppose.
Yeah, there were so many creeps, it was hard to get like an arrow, like a clean arrow shot.
Yeah, Nightstalker, I don't think he had mana for Void. I think he just threw silence on Morphling and was hoping that Ron, I got like a double Star Storm, but maybe some player error, but definitely good for DC that Morphling survives that gank. And
this is actually pretty huge. This Warlock's already level 5, even though he died once. He's like way over the other two supports on the side of DC, just chain pulling constantly.
Yeah. One thing I think is really important for this Beastmaster, which he probably should have been doing, is blocking that hard camp.
Lane, Faith Bian and Ice Ice finding Misery, trapping him their side of the wall.
If you're not going to be contesting the offlane, it's really important that you prevent the supports or the carry from just stacking that camp over and over and pulling it. Such a substantial amount of farm.
Yeah, with that time spent top as well, Blink did give a bit more space to Weeha, but as we're seeing, Blink was already very far ahead in terms of farm in comparison to Weeha. Definitely winning the lane at the moment, this Mirana. Weeha is going to need quite a bit more time before he's able to turn up, get to the point that he wants to be on that slot with the Shadow Blade and Echo Saber and such.
He's only level 6 after this pull.
It's not bad at all. Seven minutes.
Pretty damn good. He even died.
So is it a case of get the 6 on him and then start to move as a group as Wings? Or what will they wait for before they start putting the pressure on as a group down lane?
I think they're content just farming. They need to find some opportunities to... You know, get a kill on a hero, and that can translate into Luna pushing a tower. I think maybe taking that tier 1 bottom is their most likely scenario. But we're going to see Warlock port up top here, trying to make some action happen. There's a lane ward spotting this out. They know what's up.
Resolution, relatively low on mana as well. Only on 100, so.
Very keen on just constantly pressuring this Morphling, though. Like with the Mirana rotation earlier, these two just staying up here the whole time. Now the Warlock as well. They just want to put as much pressure to make sure Rezo doesn't farm.
Yeah, and here's our, you know, daytime again. Nightstalker, much more limited for the next 4 minutes. Looks like we might see a smoke here from DC headed towards the bottom lane. Want to push that tower with Beastmaster.
Looks like Wings already knew that. They were pinging
they
on
were
that
pinging
hill,
behind
right?
That
yeah,
tower
they knew something
there's
was there.
Something going on behind here.
Wouldn't be surprised if we see Shadow TP or even just rotate out of this.
He's just gonna
TP. Yeah. They knew something was up.
Yeah, really good reading them out there from Wings and Shadow GS to join the rest of the boys up top on Wings. Looking towards that tier 1. Fortification already coming out from DC. And Wings with the wraparound.
Yep, he's gonna get. That's a tower as well. And they don't even have to expend any ultimates. That's a big rotation there for Wings.
Yeah, nice bit of cash for the Ice Ice with the last touch as well on the Shaker.
Good map awareness for sure. And they even forced the glyph out in the mid lane with Blink, so now they actually have like free damage on that. And now they're even making another rotation for Rezo. He comes mid and the Nightstalker moves instantly.
Rezo's gotta be careful. He will have Saxa as well nearby. And Resolution already backing up behind the tier 2, so it looks like they won't catch him out. Saxa still remaining mid, and that's going to be the target as Faith Bian coming in with the backup of Y on the Warlock. TP coming through, but Saxa, he's already gone. TP will be cancelled from Misery. He doesn't want to join Saxa's fate.
They might lose two towers here.
Yeah, they're going to lose two. I think they're getting a... DC's getting a tower bottom, though, during this, at the very least, so it gives Moon and Wii some space. But definitely not wanting to lose your Rubick and your Undying and then lose these two towers without having any ultimates expended from Wings.
Beastmaster and Slark up here now. They have a ward, though. It spots both of these rotations.
Yeah, Weeha knows, though. He's slowed down. He's pinging it out. But it's placed in a very high up position. Not sure if they'll be able to... Yeah, no, it's not. That's just normal sentry range.
Shadow moving back in. And Wings, they did TP out a couple, but now have moved back up top. So again, they've got four members up here. Chaotic offering ready to go from Y.
I don't think DC can fight this.
Yeah, that's the thing. Is they see all these heroes coming and they say, like, oh, we really want to defend this tier 1, but and we just ported our Slark and Beastmaster here, but can we actually fight?
It's like it's daytime, but you're playing versus Murana ult, Luna ult, Warlock with Fatal Bonds, even Earthshaker 6 now too with Arcane Boots.
Yeah.
Yeah, they just can't apply any pressure on the map anywhere else.
There's an ult.
Ah, dropping it straight away onto Moon and Saxon. Moon will pop the roar onto Y. Misery incredibly low on the back of it all. And look at the position of Blink. He's trying to finish off Saxon. Will be held back by the telekinesis. They've lost Misery. If there's anything more, Moon trying to get himself out, but the Shadow Word is there, ticking him down. Shadow finishes it off with a Lucent Beam as Wings pick themselves up a second kill on top of bringing that tower down as well. So Wings continuing to keep this flow going, and as expected, when Wings are there in numbers, it's hard for DC to fight against it.
Just, it's very greedy for DC to try to defend these towers with the lineup that they have. You know, picking this Morphling and Slark together, they can't contest these tier 1s at all.
Can Saxa play his way out of this?
Is he going to the nudes?
Is he going to get to the night?
No, he tried. Another kill for Blink. Now it's 5.2k on Murana. He's doing very, very well this game.
Yeah.
And that fight up top looks so easy for Wings. The execution barrier is like pretty low. Just drop a rock. It doesn't even have to be that good. Just DC can't do anything because their cores are a Slark and a Morphling.
Looking to try something out. Bottom lane as such, if you've got the Shaker in and APN on the Night Stalker, but I'm going to respect both Moon and Misery in the neighborhood.
Now they've got darkness, vision limited.
Yep, two towers down.
Yep, two towers down. Now they're just content with farming up, you know, waiting for the golem they don't have. They're not in any rush now at all.
No.
It's just the kind of like scenario that's been happening.
Much smarter and calculated play from Wings today.
Yep.
Got Faith Bian, eyes onto Saxa, Ice, and White, chasing him down as well.
Fish
will
Echo
be up in a few seconds.
Value for the earned charge.
Worth echoing? I mean, I guess, why not? It's he did have Fisher up in a second or two, but maybe worried about TPs or turnaround coming in.
I mean, even if a big fight comes in the next, 2 minutes, I don't think he really needs Echo.
Yeah.
I think Wings are so far ahead in terms of both gold and just team fight ability that Echo is just icing on the cake.
There's no deep push from DC, like especially when Rubick's dead, there's literally nothing they can do to pull the creep wave. It's like, okay, like axes or decay, I guess, from the Undying, but that's not really optimal like movement. This should just be a free easy tier 2, and that's a lot of map control now going for the side of Wings, especially with this Night Stalker now too, and he should have, I mean, he's going to have a fairly quick, like, Aghanim Scepter. Yeah.
This has got to be scary for DC, indeed. Down bottom, trying to stop the push from Misery and Moon.
I mean, they need to just go, like, super hardcore split push. Like, I mean, this Undying's going to... He's probably feeling really sad.
Yeah, Moon's in trouble as well. You can see Wings just closing in on me. He's going to go for the TP out. And
very close.
Very, very close.
Yeah, now they just group up. Now they're like, all right, I guess we're all naturally here.
Just
so, bottom tower.
Yep.
It's like super telling that we haven't seen a tombstone or a roar a single time yet.
Yep.
I think we saw one roar when they dropped the rock, and it was just it didn't do anything. It was just kind of, we need to do something in response, and yeah, nothing came upon it. They still ended up losing the team fight, not finding any kills in return.
Their draft is just like, I don't even know what their path to victory Radiant looks like. I can't even picture it.
Yeah, I don't know. They can't fight. They can never actually fight in this game.
They can't fight. They have a really hard time split pushing, and it's only going to get harder the later the game goes. So,
Warlock Midas now, too, so the supports are super rich on the side of Wings.
mean, I guess ideally you hope Wings makes a mistake and you get a pick off with Beastmaster Roar and plus one.
Them trying to maybe Wings trying to defend towers or something, or roaming alone, you know, not grouping up, and DC kind of walking into them or finding them while they're spread out.
Is that all he has? Holy crap. Treads a killer.
He's on the same level as the Night Stalker in terms of farm.
I like that he carries entries. That's actually my favorite when I see Slark's doing that. And by my favorite, I mean it's the most annoying thing ever when you're a support versus it. But yeah, just they're super limited in their options in this game.
It's got the sentries and the Iron Talon. Yeah. Ready to clear your cliff wards.
They feel so pressured too. Like DC's even using a scan in their own jungle. They have two wards on that side too, but they didn't see anybody, but they're like, okay, we're still afraid.
Oh, look at this right around from my side. He has an Invis rune as well. This could really be painful here for DC and Moon in particular, as the walk-in Echo Slam from Invis is there. Another kill for Wings.
Almost got Blink Dagger.
Yeah, that's a great bit of cash bonus for Ice Ice.
Ah, what's up, guys?
Oh, they got a MP just got a hot sauce shipment?
No,
or is that their jerseys?
They got jerseys.
Oh, those actually look pretty cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Except there's a gambling website on the back of it.
Is there really? Oh, okay, never mind then.
Let's not go there.
All right.
Money is money when you're brand new.
That's fine.
This Morphling is sad right now. He's like, I got nowhere to farm, guys. All right, let me just go top. Some creeps here.
Yeah, Axe nearly done for Blink on his Murano. Only a few hundred gold away. As you said, the options, the kind of the game plans for DC looking to be Lies Misery. Kind of chasing down Y here. With Weehawk, he has
so
a sentry.
He knows.
He drops one sentry.
He saw Wee on the right from that ward that they have on the high ground. Able to just juke around and hide, TP out.
Sentry down and
He knows the ward's there now.
Yep. Do they want to go for a smoke here? Looks like Misery wanted something. He was pinging that out, but...
They want anything, man. They just...
They need something.
Give
I mean.
Us a kill at something.
This could result in one. Moon getting in position, but he can't quite get close enough.
I think the Luna also went for like a semi-contingency plan just in case. He went the Dominator instead of like the Yasha that we've been seeing more often. He's just stacking.
Look how confident those supports are.
Midas Earthshaker.
Double Midas.
He has the Blink Gold. He says, screw it.
Oh, he sold it. he's trolling.
He's trolling.
He probably bought it and his team was like, dude.
I'm dying arrowed. It's not good for him.
Oh my goodness.
And that might not be the only kill that they get, but the Chaotic Offing dropped onto Moon. Lucid Beam as well. They'll chase for a second and again a roar. But
there's
amounts
roar,
to nothing.
That's one. That's the second roar.
Second roar.
All right.
Used as he dies, his dying breath each time in these fights. But 11 for 2, Wings, certainly looking very dominant.
Now he's going for the Midas. Yeah. He doesn't. Yeah,
he's like, we just want to fight. You didn't need bubbling. I'm farming.
I mean, contingency plan, you know, just in case.
Yeah.
Of some, I don't know, something disastrous that happens. I don't know.
Now I guess
Slark.
That's just one.
Yeah,
right?
He actually bought it. What a boss.
If Wings just walks down a lane, can DC do anything?
Well, I mean, probably not.
I wonder if he's actually worried about being able to high ground. Maybe that's why he bought it, but...
I mean, if he was worried about that, shouldn't he just go Blink now and try
Wings
higher?
Just getting a little clowny. You know?
I think they're getting a little bit clowny. That is definitely safe to say.
Just having a little fun. You were here at the Summit 6, you know? Casual land.
Oh, man. DC?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
They're finding something.
They might get it as well.
They're finding something.
They also might need to defend their base.
That's true, actually.
Yeah.
They probably need to defend that base. That's important. There's their deep push.
There it is. Fade bolted. Hit the catapult as well. Reduce damage.
Dying might show up later and decay someone.
They need something. I mean, they may be getting Roche, but this is falling. There we have it. They've now got the Aegis onto Weehawk. Resolution to TP him first. The tower already down to a third of its life.
There's the Undying, dude.
Well, that is something for DC.
Yeah, that's definitely something.
I think that's definitely worth for them, considering the position they were in.
Yeah, definitely. They have these big teamfight ultimates. And
I'm pretty much Shadowblade Gold now done for Weehawk.
Are they going to get him here?
Mm.
He's gonna know something's up.
He spent all
up.
His money, so there's a plus. He's got the Aegis.
He thinks there's a warden there now. See that? Because it's being revealed.
Shadow. Yeah, Asha done, and indeed, as we see Shadow and Blink still quite a fair bit ahead of the two cores, Weehan, Rezo, DC.
He gives Shadow a sentry.
I mean, now with this Shadow Blade, can he move around the map and look to find pickoffs, or is this a very hard team to do that against the way the Wings are playing?
I think it's hard, but he sort of has to.
I mean, he can't really kill anybody though, right? Like, even Earthshaker and Warlock survived the burst.
I mean, he's got to do it
with the Beastmaster.
Yeah, with other people, obviously. So even with that Aegis, I still don't think they can win a team fight.
At least we do ready to try and get a bit more vision back of the map. Beastmaster Moon getting that Necro leveled up. Blink Dagger as well done on Blink.
Gem picked up now for Warlock.
Alright, solution very close to his Lincoln Sphere as well. So it's going to get to the point where DC can kind of step up that split push game and feel a little safer in terms of getting pressure out and making sure that they don't have all lanes pushed in against them as Wings come through with this 5-man. But yeah, this Ags
Gem. It's time.
It's rough.
Night Stalker's online.
Yeah. I mean, Peter, you're talking about how scary it is if he gets to there the late game. If he gets there at 20 minutes, it's pretty terrifying, I can imagine, if you're playing up against that.
Most definitely is.
Spot the ward. He's going to walk right by it. And then are they going to catch?
Who's down at the moment? Saxa and Misery jump in. We have to Blink away. Moon will drop the roar onto Mirana, but already being healed up by the Shadow Word. Blink is going to survive. Leaps away. Chaotic now. Dropped onto Moon. Moon's to fall. They've lost two on DC. Coming in with the ult as well. Weeha trying to get himself away with the Shadow Blade, but indeed they see him. They'll take him down. Pop the Aegis. And Rezo's got to run. The question is, can they kill him a second time, Weeha? As the initial void, trying to dart back to Wei. Faith Bian closing down. Off the ward first.
They want to chase.
He's got the silence. He can certainly try for it. Still under the cover of nighttime as well. It's a great time for them to fight. And Wings, they take four, including the Aegis. Resolution, the only one to survive. And now on top of the Midas, Ice, he's got the Blink Dagger Golden. Well, talking about
Midas,
I said he was getting out. He's not getting out. He's down as well. 21 minutes in, 16-3. Wings just continuing to essentially run over this DC draft. And there's your Blink. We'll take that timing on the Earthshaker. He's going to be more than happy, and his team's going to be relieved.
Midas equal Worf.
It's looking pretty rough for DC here this game.
Yeah, very methodical plays coming out for Wings.
Yeah.
Since there's no team fight really on the side of DC, like we've mentioned, like they're very free to just like kind of throw ultimates at people. Like, it's like, oh, there's one hero here, we're just going to drop a rock on him. Oh, there's like one other hero here, we're going to Echo Slam him.
Just jumping, immediately looking to delete a hero from the side. Moon to fall, the tombstone's down, but Wings quickly taking it out of the game despite the soul reveal. And Faith Bian just turns towards Misery, picks up a second. And here's the push that you talked about and questioned whether they could stop, and the answer is they cannot. DC, call it, GG, throw in the towel. Another very quick game here at the Summit, 22 minutes. Wings, I mean, Peter, was this always going to be the case from the draft, or was there a way that DC could have made this work?
I don't think the Slark pick did anything for them. I think when that pick came out, I think their fate was kind of sealed. Maybe if they would have like dominated their lanes, but pretty hard to do against Lunar Warlock.
Yeah, definitely a bit greedy, I feel. Like, just the Morphling and the Slark together, just